Hi, in this video, we are going to see how to balance ionic equation in acidic condition. So before we begin, let's look at the six steps that are involved. So the first step is we have to identify which is the oxidation and reduction equation and write it out. Then we will balance all elements except for hydrogen and oxygen. Then we will balance oxygen using water and hydrogen using proton. Then we will balance the charges for the two equations using electrons and make sure that the two equations have the same number of electrons by multiplying with a common denominator. And lastly, add up the two half reactions and we will be done. So let's begin by balancing the equation in acidic solution. So this is the given equation. So the first step that we need to do is to write out the half reaction equations. So in order for us to do that, we need to first identify which component undergoes oxidation and which component undergoes reduction. So in order to do that, we will need to identify the oxidation number, and here are the calculated oxidation numbers for each of the element. So you can see SO3 2- to SO4 2-, the sulfur undergoes oxidation. So that would be our term for oxidation. And we will write it out as our half equation right now, just the way it is. SO3 2- going to SO4 2-. And for reduction, we have MnO4- going to MnO2. And you can see it is a reduction because the oxidation number reduced from +7 for Mn to +4 for Mn. So therefore, the reduction equation is MnO4- going to MnO2. So we are now done with step 1. Moving on, step 2, we need to balance all the elements except for hydrogen and oxygen. So for our half equations, S and Mn are already balanced, so we can just proceed to the next step. So for step 3, we are supposed to balance the oxygen using water and H+ using proton. So for the oxidation equation, we have SO3 2- going to SO4 2-. So on the right hand side here, we have one extra oxygen, and therefore we will need to balance that by placing water on the left hand side. So now we have the same number of oxygen on both sides. But because we added water, now we have two extra hydrogen on the left hand side, which now we will need to do by adding 2H+ on the right hand side. So as you can see now, our oxidation equation is now balanced in terms of the atoms for sulfur, oxygen and hydrogen. For the reduction equation, we have MnO4- going to MnO2. So you can see on the left hand side, we have two extra oxygen, and we can balance by adding two water on the right hand side. So now oxygen wise, we are balanced, four on the left hand side, four on the right hand side. But again, since we added water on the right hand side, now we have four extra hydrogen, which we will need to balance by adding 4H+ on the left hand side. Step 4. We will now balance the charges with electrons. So for both our equations, this is what we have so far. For our oxidation equation, we have a negative charge on the left hand side and zero charge on the right hand side. So we will need to balance that by adding 2 electrons on the right hand side. So now overall charge for the right hand side is 2-. And here it's 2-. For the reduction equation, we have an overall charge of -1 + 4, which gives us a +3 on the left hand side. And over here we have 0 + 0, so that's 0. So we will need to balance the charge by making this side equal to 0. And that is by adding 3 electrons. So the fifth step is to equalize the loss and gain of electrons. So for our oxidation equation on the top here, we have 2 electrons over here. And for our reduction equation, we have 3 electrons. So what we will need to do is equalize and make sure that these two number of electrons are the same. And we can do so by finding the common denominator. So we can achieve that by multiplying the oxidation equation by 3, and that will give us 6 electrons. and you need to multiply that across for the entire equation. So now all we have to do for the final step is to add up the half reactions. So what I've done here is I've written out the oxidation and reduction equations after multiplying in 3 for the oxidation equation and 2 for the reduction equation. So now what we will do is we will simplify the equations. So we will do so by taking care of the electrons. Both 6 electrons on the right and the left side of the equations will be taken out. Then we will simplify H+. On the oxidation side, we have 6 H+. And on the reduction side, we have 8 H+. So we can simplify that by removing the 6 H+ in oxidation, leaving us with 2 H+ on the reduction side. Next, it's water. So on the oxidation side, we have 3 H2O. On the reduction side, we have 4 H2O. So to simplify, we will take out the 3 H2O on the oxidation side, and that will leave us with 1 H2O on the reduction side. So now what we do is we just carry down all the terms and add them together. So this is our final answer. Congratulations, we are done.